Well, we are back. We have made it through another week of life. And that is actually an accomplished thing to make it through a week of life. So it looks like we've got a bunch of the same gents, and probably one lady in the background who have joined us for our Saturday set. And I just briefly started reading through the comments and did want to say condolences to Jason. If you guys did not see at the top, I think his, did he say wife's mother or father passed away? Let me go back up and look. Yeah, his wife's dad passed away. So sincere condolences to you, Jason. I don't know if you're close to your wife's parents. It's been crazy. I've been unfortunate, at least in the past, unfortunate with the girls that I choose. I'm not very good at choosing girls to date or marry, but I've always lucked out when it comes to the girls' parents. I think some of you know this, but I was married before, got divorced. In my first marriage, obviously, I got divorced, but her parents were fucking awesome. Like, still to this day, her mom sometimes says something to me on Facebook, and we kind of interact here and there. And it's been a long, long time since that happened. And of course, my current wife's family is absolutely awesome. And in a couple months, actually, we get to go back and see them when we go back to Korea. As long as this pandemic is actually finally ending, although Korea right now is getting crushed. I think they're having like 200,000 cases a day, which is crazy. I have a whole theory or thought on Korea's handling of the pandemic. I think it was absolutely brilliant, and I think they probably did one of the best jobs of dealing with a pandemic in the world. But right now they're getting crushed. So Omicron hopefully is gonna, I think they should probably hit their peak. I thought maybe this week or next week, and maybe they have. And then hopefully it starts going down, and then I will be going there in June to get to see my family. So all that to say, Jason, I don't know if you are close to your wife's parents, but if you are, even if you aren't, it's still a shitty situation. So we will make up for it. And ironically, the theme for today that Jason has picked has fit this kind of unfortunate situation. So I saw that he was asked, and unlike Scott K, he didn't give it away. Nice job, Jason. Scott's like a little kid at Christmas who can't stand not telling people what's in the gifts before they open them. Kids like that always ruin Christmas. Scott, you're a ruining of Christmas. But at least Jason didn't. So I will tell everybody what we got in store today in just one second. But now I want to say that this video is sponsored by, just kidding. It's funny when I watch reaction channels, because I've told you guys I watch reaction channels a lot. And to watch reaction channels that weren't big before become big, and they all of a sudden have to do these stupid ass sponsors. Fuck that, man. I hate that shit. I mean, even if somebody was like, depending on how much they pay, I mean, everyone has a price, but I'm not gonna fucking ruin my video and my stream because some retarded company. I mean, I cannot stand commercials, which I still don't understand how we pay as much as we do in the United States for cable access and still have to deal with the fucking retarded commercials. It's absolutely sad. I think there should be an option that, no, not like the box. I know you have the box and you can fast forward through the commercials, but there should be definitely an option where you pay an extra $10 a month or something, and you literally never have to see a fucking commercial in your life because they're stupid. I literally will not buy something when I'm like in the middle of a show and I like it, and then a stupid dumb commercial comes in. I will be like, I will not buy that thing ever because they ruined the situation. So, yeah, I don't pay for cable either. So, especially because it's out of control. Like, when I got back, I was shocked to see that like people in my family were paying like $160 just for regular cable. It's like, you gotta be smoking crack. That's a car payment for fucking. And most of the shit that's on TV sucks. It absolutely sucks. It's a waste of time. So yeah, I don't do that either. Oh, we got Rasmus back. What's up, buddy? I think you're a guy. And so anyway, I got sidetracked there. Yeah, so I think it's funny in these videos when they're like, oh, the sponsor says, fuck, get out of here. Unless you pay me like $100,000 or something, I'm not doing some stupid, today's sponsor is for 2 minutes and then go back. Can't pay me enough for that. Sorry, I'll pass. All right, so let's get into this set. Jason says this. He says, with the sad death of the legend known as Meatloaf. So as I said, it fits kind of the situation that Jason led off the stream with by having a death in the family. With the sad death of the legend known as Meatloaf, I have felt that I should share a set list of some of his top classic songs as a send-off. Meatloaf was a great artist who exemplifies the theatricality and creativeness that some artists only strive for. His influence is seen in many bands, and the man himself has touched the hearts of many artists who toured with him or met him. So we are going to do a set list of Meatloaf today. I don't know how many of you guys, I know the famous songs by Meatloaf, but I don't really know that much by Meatloaf other than that I know of. It might be one of those things where it's a Meatloaf song and I just never knew it, even though I know the song very well. So we'll find out about that. Does anybody else like Meatloaf or know Meatloaf or anything like that? So I'd be interested to hear how many people like Meatloaf or know Meatloaf. Because if you don't, like me, you're going to be listening to some songs today by him. So here we go. Uh-oh, did you see the microphone crackle? Is it too loud? Can't be too loud, right? Anybody else having that problem with, like, Colin? I thought I had this, like, microphone thing figured out. It's right in front of me, but maybe I need to turn it down or not speak so loud. All right. Yeah, I'm surprised Michael doesn't like him. He says he's just okay. I would think Michael would like that kind of stuff. It kind of is his generational pull. But all right, so let's get into this first song. It's a banger. It's a 12-minute long song. And it's the song that I know by Meatloaf. I Would Do Anything for Love. I think if you don't know this song, you've been living under a rock or not paying attention to music for a long time. He says, and we begin with my personal favorite song of his and of many of his fans, known also for the amazing music video that accompanies the song, this chilling love story of which retells Beauty and the Beast in the video, grabbed the hearts of many romantics and left us with a mystery that some still haven't solved, but those who have appreciate. The words, I would do anything for love, but I won't do that, have been repeated in all forms of media still to this day. I didn't choose the music video version despite wanting to hear Cap Jewel over Lorraine Crosby, as it cuts out a portion of the song and I like the parts it cuts out. Do I need to put a filter on this? Because if it's this song, I would guess that it would be pretty, I guess it would be blocked pretty quickly. So should I? Yeah, I'm trying to think. Maybe if I see the warning thing come up, I'm gonna do it. But here we go with I Would Do Anything for Love. Okay, here we go. Is this right? Or am I playing the wrong song? This is Bat Out of Hell. Maybe I put them in the wrong order? I know this is it, right? I don't remember it starting like this. It sounds kind of low. I'm going to turn it up. It's like really loud in this ear and just a little bit in this one. Because the piano. Suspect. What's up, John Feeney? Are you gonna like say hi and then leave again? Baggins is here. It's bad, like as bad as in good or bad as in bad. Baggins. And back.
I would do anything for love. I'll never lie to you, and that's a fact.
And that's a fact.
But I'll never forget the way you feel right now.
You mean in the picture?
No.
Jean-Francois?
No,
in the picture?
Way. And I would do anything for love. But I won't.
Baggins, she didn't like the singing.
No, I won't do anything for love. Oh, I would do anything.
It was actually Denver. Denver, Colorado. Downtown Denver.
Anything for love. But I won't do that. No, I won't do that.
This part sounds like a... a John Cougar Mellencamp song.
And some days it don't come easy. And some days it don't come hard. Some days it don't come...
Never listen to the whole words of the song.
These are the days that never end.
These are the days that never end.
Some nights you're breathing fire.
Breathing fire.
Some nights you're like nothing I've ever seen before. Will again. Maybe I'm crazy.
Nice halftime.
Oh, it's crazy.
Halftime is life, baby.
I know you can save me. No one else can save me now but you. As long as the flag is burning.
This is like Flashdance. Footloose. Adrian, that's a good point. It does. Like, it covers look like it should be, like, heavy metal. Ozzy Osbourne stuff.
Take a vow and seal a pact. But I'll never forgive myself if we don't go all the way. Tonight, and I would do anything for love.
Ryan, I think Michael would be happy about that. Yeah, this song definitely has all the components of an 80s song. Just like the building and the piano sounds very Rocky-ish. But Lucy. Breakdown. Whammy bar. Oh, this is from 93. Wow. Well, still got the 80s sound to me. Very, Rocky Horror Picture Show kind. I remember being in maybe elementary or middle school and going to that at 12 o'clock. Wow, Michael Bay directed the music video? No, it didn't.
And some days I pray for silence. And some days I pray for soul. Some days I just pray to the god of sex and drums and rock and roll.
Sex and drums and rock and roll? Drugs, I think he said. It sounded like drums, but...
Some nights I lose control.
I like that.
Some nights I just lose it
all. The piano high pitch. Halftime again. This song has a really good like back and forth between the build and the halftime. Hard not to when you know this part so well. So if this is an 11 minute song, obviously on the radio they didn't play the whole 11 minutes, so I wonder what the radio version was. It was just like 5 minutes. Yeah, that's exactly what I was just saying, Colin. Yeah, me too, Michael. So I just wonder if it's like, I do remember this part, like the build here and stuff. Yeah, Baggins, that's what I think, which is why I didn't know the other stuff. In the different years.
But I'll never stop dreaming of you every night of my life.
Baggins, it's like most pop songs. The chorus just like repeats 30 times. Nice word there, Colin.
Blimey. Can you colorize my life? I'm so sick of black and white. Can
you
make
it all a
little less old? I can do that.
I can do that. I had to show up, Colin. See, once again, man, John Feedy comes in, says hi, and then he disappears. Are you cradling the baby?
Oh, I would do anything for love. I would do anything for love.
This I remember. This was like the ending of the song. It's like. Nice resolve. And there we come to the end of the first I Would Do Anything for Love, but I won't do that. I feel like a radio DJ right now. Next up, we will be talking about the weather forecast. Friday, Thursday will be rainy. Saturday will be cloudy. It's exactly like a great, you know, ending to that song. Is I'm sure that's happened on a billion radio stations a billion times. Brian, you just got blocked. I have to show your, because you said fuck. I don't know why our culture just can't get over bad words, because they're not really bad words unless you use them in the context of bad words, but you can say a bunch of other words that are used in the bad sense that aren't cuss words. Fuck is an adjective. Fuck, man, shit. It's like an exclamation. Holy crap. Holy shit. Same thing. Just get over it. Our culture's so Puritan. Just fucking, who cares? Speaking of theatrics, ironically, this just reminded me, since this was kind of theatrical and Meatloaf is known for being theatrical, tonight I am going back to my high school for the first time in, I don't know, so long, because the theater group or the theater program at my high school, and I know everyone says this, but this is actually true with my, everyone says this, but it's not necessarily true. This is actually true with my high school theater program, at least I don't know about today, but for a long, long time, it was one of the premier theater schools, like theater programs in the country, not just like in Ohio, but like in the country. Most theater school, high schools, public high schools will do like maybe a big musical one, you know, during the year, and then maybe like one or two plays. My high school, we did like 10 to 11 plays and usually a big musical and then like a smaller musical like Nonsense or something like that at the end. And, I made a big transition from playing soccer and baseball in the jock world my whole life to like my sophomore year of, some of you have heard this, my sophomore year of high school going into theater. The first show I was ever in was Hello Dolly, which was like on, you know, the big musical of that year. And I loved it. I had a great experience during theater and stuff like that and really enjoyed it. And I just did it for fun, never thought to be good at it or anything like that. And I'm going back tonight to go see their performance of Mamma Mia, which I'm not really familiar. I know the music a little bit to that because it's an ABBA kind of thing, but I don't know the show very well. But I'm going to go back to my high school. It's going to be so weird to walk in the halls of my high school. I graduated in 96, and I think I've maybe been back there through the halls once since then. So you're talking over 25 years. So it'll be interesting to walk through the halls and just, I think, because I'm a very sentimental person, if it's just going to like hit me or if I'm just going to be like, holy shit, or if it looks, it might look completely different than what it used to. I'm sure they've done updates to the school since I've been there. But anyway, I'm going back to watch Mamma Mia at my high school, which I find funny because I knew, like, you know, they do these plays to try to make money for the school, blah, 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 blah. But this was a $15 ticket to go see a high school musical. It's like, is everybody in the world using the pandemic to just rip people off? Or is it normally that they charge $15 for a stupid high school performance of something? Like, maybe 10 is pushing it, but 15 is certainly out of control high for a fucking high school musical show. So yeah, I was like, okay, I'm gonna do this one time, but I think I'm gonna go. They have like the big theater where, you know, auditorium, where pretty much every high school has a big auditorium. That's where they're gonna do the big musical, but they do all the other plays in a small black box theater, which is kind of to the right down the hall. And I'm going to go to one of those by the end of the year as well, because I want to see that. Because I spent most of my time in the Black Box Theater. We only did one show in the main auditorium. And then all the theater stuff was based in the Black Box Theater. Like my theater repertory class was in that. So that'll bring back a bunch of memories to go in there and see it. So I'll probably do that. But anyway, let's get back to the theatrics of Meatloaf. Number two, this is Paradise by the Dashboard Light. I definitely don't know this song. This is another 8-minute. Dude, is he's like a progressive boy. Like, we're in like Manny situation here. We've got a 12-minute song and now an 8.5-minute song. The story of a pair of teenagers on the edge of becoming adults with one another in the backseat of a car is both hilarious and real as you hear Meatloaf try to worm his way out of telling the girl that he loves her. I use the music video, probably going to cause it to get blocked, sadly and sorry, because of the impact of a certain moment and better emphasized by watching Meatloaf actually react to the situation in the song. So you obviously don't want to block it, you just want to let it get blocked, and I'll try to do the dispute, and hopefully Meatloaf in the grave is like, hey, that's cool. So this is Paradise by the Dashboard Light. Here we go. Cool. It's like a 12 bar. And I never had a girl looking any better than you did. And all the kids at school, they were wishing they were me that night. And now our bodies are so close and tight. It never felt so good, it never felt so right. Oh, nice, Adrian. Daughter's gonna be an actress in Hollywood. And then you're gonna be the guy that shows up to the Hollywood party playing shit music that they don't all like. It's not Miley Cyrus. Oh, halftime. Dude, he is good at switching from like the da 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 to. She looks like Rocky Horror Picture Show. She does, especially with that like rosy cheek. Warning, heads up, we've detected copyright audio and video. I gotta do it, Michael, I'm sorry. It's gonna stop the actual stream. See if we can get it. See if that works. Was he really in it? That's funny. I just remember the guy with the black hair and that looks like this woman. The main character. It's a good song. This is a nice bluesy song. It sounds like something that would be in like Greece. Yeah, this is like something that would be in Greece. Eddie the Motorcycle Dude. I'm not familiar with the show enough. I just remember throwing rice at the wedding. Throwing it hard at people. That's such a dickhead as a kid. I have not seen that movie since I was throwing rice at people and falling asleep in the theater close to them. Ryan, I did see that. I'm definitely on board. I think that's a great idea. I think it's cool. It's unique. It's open-minded. It's exactly what we need on this channel. Take note, everyone. Ryan came up with a cool idea. And if we can make that more fun, that'll be great. Ooh, is he kissing her? Nice. Is that Hitler? Yeah, it's still not going away. I hope the stream doesn't go down. Mm-hmm. Rizzuto. At first it looked like Hitler, but I think it was the newspaper person or the refreshments person, and then I saw the guy sliding into second base. You're listening to the music? The music's pretty good in this. Ah, yes. Now I'm putting two together. Thank you, Michael. Because I wasn't paying attention enough. Before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me awake? Do you love me? That's a great idea too, Jason. And yeah, Baggins, I'm loving it. This is good. This totally reminds me of Grease. It's literally the Grease. Like even like the rock and roll aspect of it. Don't take it seriously, Colin. I think baseball is... I played baseball my whole life. It is the boringest sport to watch next to golf. I love playing them. Play baseball all day long, but to fucking watch it is retarded. Although in Korea, they go... It's a whole different experience to watch a baseball game in Korea. It's like the whole fucking stadium is cheerleaders for the whole game. And then you get hot little Korean girls dancing on the dugouts. Like cheerleaders. Oh. I thought you were saying like, oh yeah, I do see the rhyme there. I thought you were saying like, oh yeah, I have that same idea. What's it gonna be, boy? Yes or no? What's it gonna be, boy? Yes? Yeah. All of your face. No. All of your face. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it. Well, let me sleep on it. Adrian, you like watching golf? I love playing it, but watching it's fucking boring as shit. Unless it's like a playoff and Tiger Woods nails one from 130 yards. Ooh, it sounds good. Look at that! I just want to say, Jason, I appreciate your ode to Meatloaf. This is a great way for us to like let him go out, because I think this is a good song. I mean, it's got like a groove to it. It's got also like that musical theatrical feel to it. Yeah, Jason, we can even take a poll. Like at the end, it's like okay, who votes for this? Who votes for that? And for even my channel, majority wins. So it would be interesting to see, like, and especially if those bands like got to watch it and see how they measured up against another band. That'd be cool. Okay, Michael. I'm like you, Michael. I don't listen to lyrics, especially on the first listen. But that's a good idea. I need to. Is this something I'd put on a playlist? Probably not, but definitely give it another listen. And I would like to see the video when she's looking at the camera like that. All right, so we made it to the second one. Yeah, I think that was... so far, I would say both songs I've liked. I wouldn't, again... I don't think I'd put them on playlists, but I've definitely liked them. And I think Meatloaf is probably, like, I wouldn't say underrated, but he certainly isn't. It's not reflective of how I think he's good, whether I like his stuff in the sense of a playlist song or not. I mean, that's good. Like, and I think he sounds good too. Like, his singing's good. I mean, I would love to have pipes like that. So yeah, I like that in the chat. We are throwing out some ideas. Maybe we can start that in March, or maybe even April or something, once we kind of get it figured out. And if people jump on board, I think those are great ideas. Speaking of, like, we have a surprise set on Monday night because nobody turned in a set until yesterday. And then yesterday and this morning when I woke up, I literally got three sets. So that means next weekend is completely taken care of, which is good. And then we can maybe figure out what we're going to do with this raffle stuff if people jump on board. We'll have to figure it out and make sure I plan it and do it right. Because if we do a raffle and people, you know, get their name chosen or whatever, I'm going to have to download the song real quick right there, whatever song they choose. Or are you saying there's a pile of songs that are already uploaded? We'll have to figure, like, those details out. All right, so let's get to the third song, which is Couldn't Have Said It Better, featuring Patty Russo. This is fucking 9 minutes and 15 seconds. Jeez, I didn't know Meatloaf wrote such fucking bangers, man. While not as well known of a song, I discovered this song when I binged Meatloaf's discography after hearing of his death and wondered why this one wasn't on his top list. Interesting. Watching the video of him performing this with Patty Russo at Benissimo, I don't know where that's at or what that is, in 2003 was amazing, and I felt I should share this incredible performance with you guys. Okay, is it going to get blocked? Is it, like, live? This is Couldn't Have Said It Better, featuring Patty Russo. This is a 9-minute song. Jesus. Manny's here. Uh-oh. Orange is going to get blocked. You guys got short hair. You have the right to remain silent. Oh, I know the song. Okay. I do know the song, or at least that nothing at all. This is going to get blocked for sure. I'm just waiting for that warning to pop up. I think his voice is good. I feel like the chord progression is just like, and I won't do that. I would do anything for love. A little low. Turning it up. There we go. Some good emotion to it. I love how she's shaking the knee. Right to remain silent, I'll get the light. You get that smile, you say nothing at all. Yes. Well, I couldn't have said it better myself. Tonight the conversation takes a fall. Nice. Just love me like you love nobody else. Just love me like you love nobody else. Is this about a prostitute? He knew he was looking right at the camera. That's what I was saying, Colin. I felt like the chords were even the same. It sounds very, very similar. Like, it's almost like... He's definitely got some, like, emotional... So many times I stumbled on the words that I wanted to say. Yeah, you say nothing at all. Oh, she got beautiful eyes. She had a great voice too. Ryan. The thing I love about this is they look like they're having a great time up there. You see people who are just performing to perform. They are definitely in it. Makes me wonder if Meatloaf passed away from a heart attack, because the dude has just got so much energy. Heart probably just gave out. Sweating? Did she just put her tongue out there for him like a snake? Yeah, look, I mean, he's got some serious emotion in him. That was good. I think that was the best song. He looks like he should be like a wrestling star. Like, he's good with the performance side.
Hey, yeah. Yeah! Oh, what an energy.
The guy's like, oh, please don't do something crazy.
Yeah, mama.
He definitely passed away of a heart attack. Or a brain aneurysm.
Hey, that's great.
Okay, I was told to cut it, but... Yeah, I like all these ideas that are flying in the chat. I do think it's easy to ignore what was just going on, but I think that performance was better than the other two. Like, as a song, I think it's a better song. More ballady poppy, but not maybe as theatrical, so it was better for me. And I just love the energy he and Miss Russo, I think is her name, has on stage. Like, they just are, you can tell they are pouring into it, and they're doing a good job. I liked it. I think that was good. Yeah, maybe like people, I don't know, maybe we can have a chat or a live chat stream that just talks about like what we can do as far as these ideas, or maybe we'd be better if you guys write me emails and we go back and forth. I don't know. I'm not a writer, so I don't typically like writing emails back, but let's get to the next one. Keep thinking about it, putting our heads together. And this is the last song of the set, actually, because the other ones were like each 10 minutes long. This one's called Rock and Roll Dreams Come True. It's only 5 minutes and 40 seconds. He says, and to end it off, I chose the anthem for rock and roll dreamers. This 1993 classic starred not only Meatloaf, but also, and only acting, the then known unknown Angelina Jolie at the age of 18. Really? The typical daughter has a fight with her dad and runs away story is classic, and who better than Meatloaf to portray the beauty of rock and roll as a salvation for the lonely heart. Interesting. So we're going to see Angelina Jolie as a little girl in this. She probably still looks hot. All right, let's try it. Oh yeah, there she is. Kind of reminds me of that Aerosmith song. Not that loud. Turn it up. Turn it up. There we go. Yeah, Jason, I really like the last song. Really good. Ryan, writing is the lowest form of communication. That's why. It sucks.
Think of how we lay down together. We've been
blessed us when he gave us. I would agree, Michael. Like, I don't think she's like top tier, but you can't deny her face is beautiful. Yeah, Michael, I'm starting to see that as well, too. I mean, I'm unfamiliar with him, but he definitely is one of the... Oh, got another copyright. Shit. I'll just let it go until I get blocked. Pretty crackhead. She's just weird. I think that's the main thing. Like, the blood vial shit that she had with... Yeah, I'm glad you guys like writing. I'm just saying it is a fact that it's the lowest form of communication. It leaves out 70% of communication, which is nonverbal. So, Michael, what it really comes down to is if she said, "I want you to bone me," you would say no? Would you actually say no to her? I wouldn't. Go with the nice. His outfits, he looks like a freaking elf. Got the Kenny G here. Once upon a time was the backbeat. Once upon a time all the chords came to life. And the angels had guitars even before they had dreams. So the angels had guitars before they had dreams? Shit, it's blocked. Ah! YouTube is so fucking annoying. Just so unbelievably stupid. All right, let's see if it comes back up. Stream. Oh, YouTube, you are so pathetic. YouTube, let the fucking thing go. Come on. Sheba. All right, here we go. It's no longer being blocked due to copyright. So, we are back. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Let's start the video again. I put a filter on and let's see if we can make it through. I think we have, I don't know, probably 3 minutes left is my guess. A lot of his, at least the songs in this set, have a lot of the same framework. So. Keep on believing, baby. got a very it's almost like he's playing the same song in a little bit of a different version. Rock and roll dreams come true. All right, Adrian, I'll remember that. Yeah, it's sad that videos make it get blocked. I think he's got a great voice. Baggins, you're gonna have to tell your daughter that his voice is really good, so she must be smoking crack. Stop giving her the crack, Baggins. She's gonna look like Angelina. Rock and roll dreams come true. Yep, I agree. Videos add so much. It's visual, which is it's not highly underrated. Was that the end? All right. Unfortunately, we got interrupted when we only had a couple minutes left in the song. But we did make it through. This was a nice little ode to Meatloaf. As I said, I wouldn't probably put Meatloaf's music on a playlist for me. But I appreciate, I think he has a fabulous voice. And speaking of videos, what we were just talking about in the videos, that videos can add a lot. The song before this that he sang with that Russo woman was so good because you could see the passion that he had when he was singing. Like, that added so much. Freaking retarded YouTube to block that shit. So, it's unfortunate. But, yes, Jason, thank you for, you know, sending Meatloaf off with a set list. I love these set lists. I love that we can do different things, as always. And let's continue to talk about the ideas that, you know, you guys were throwing out there today, and we'll see what we can come up with for something. Again, I don't have a ton of time to, like, you know, do a lot of extra work on the side, so something that is conducive to what you guys are saying, as well as not having to for me to do a bunch of more work to do it, would be most beneficial, because, you know, I do have a full-time job, so coming home and doing a second time job or whatever is not something I would like to put too much time in, because this does take some time to do it. I enjoy it, so it's not really a big a deal, but let's try to find some place that accomplishes both of those things if we can. So love that we all are putting our heads together. I'll try to think of some stuff too, and we will be back here tomorrow with Adrian's set. Adrian's sets are always good as well. And then, of course, we've got next week Jean-Francois now, and Colin have sets next weekend. So have a great Saturday, and we will see you guys here at the same time, hopefully. And yeah, we'll enjoy the sounds of Adrian, what he brings us. Alrighty, so have a great Saturday. We'll see you tomorrow morning. Peace.